Really, really young, of course, like many Godzilla fans, I was into dinosaurs. I just thought dinosaurs were the greatest thing ever. And then you see Godzilla. I didn't even see a Godzilla movie. I got a birthday card. It had this big garish green Godzilla on it. And like my neurons are all firing, and I'm just wondering what is this? Well, as far as a career in comics go, to be perfectly honest, as much as I loved Godzilla, the idea of actually doing Godzilla something professional as far as Godzilla goes was always a very far away option. I contacted Chris Ryle of IDW and I said, here's my stuff. I love Transformers, I'm a big fan. Here's what I can do, have any work. He said, yes, we are working on a Beast Wars character compilation book. We need some backup artists. So that was good that I was able to form a connection there. And I did a few other Transformers jobs after that, nothing really solid. I got a call from Chris Mirjahangir, and he said, dude, the company that you worked with, IDW, they just got the Godzilla lines. They just made an announcement about it. So I emailed Chris Ryle. About a week or so later, that was when Ryle contacted me and asked me, do you want to do this Stomp cover promotion? I've been working practically around the clock on new stuff. I'm working on a number of Transformers projects. We're working on Kaiju Combat, which is a fighting game. My friend Chris Mirjahangir recently completed work on his little movie that I contributed demon designs for. The movie's called Transcendence. I did these designs for these demons that he put into the film. These cool CGI demons, just constantly moving. Stuff's constantly happening. In Toho Studios.
Escucha.
My girlfriend Morgan and I we've been wanting to come to Japan for a while now. We both are so in love with the country. We just really wanted to finally just do it. One of the perks about being a Godzilla artist and working with Toho and working on this franchise is actually getting to meet people, other people, people that you have idolized your whole life. One of the really amazing things, for example, was when we went to dinner with Takeshi Yagi, the director of my personal favorite Ultraman movie, the Super 8 Ultra Brothers. We went to this temple for this bird festival, but it was at this Shinto temple, the Shinto shrine, and there's all this street food and just packed with people, and that was really cool. Just to kind of go through that was really amazing. And then we went to have okonomiyaki, and it was amazing, and just talking with him and drinking with him and just having a grand old time with him and all the new friends that I've made over here. Just today we went to Shinichi Wakasa's studio at Monsters, Inc. And that can't even describe. I actually started tearing up a little bit. Just to see all of these amazing props and suits and puppets and sculpts and the stuff they were working on, which was amazing. Just to see the stuff actually being made.
怪物を作りたいっていうのが僕の、なんだろう、本当の心の声じゃなくて、やっぱりその面白い映画を作る、映画を作ることを協力するために僕はこの仕事をずっとやってきたんで、やっぱり面白い映画に巡り合うことかな。その面白い映画で僕たちの能力が発揮できる、そういう怪物のスーツだったりっていうことができることが一番望ましいんだけど。
We have, it's very similar when doing art, when drawing, or it's not so much having a favorite thing to draw, it's aspects, it's being involved in it, it's the process.
Just to think, I was sitting next to Godzilla, was unbelievable. I get goosebumps just thinking about it.
What did you do before then? Did you go straight into suit acting, or were you doing a lot of stunt work, just general stunt work?
初めからスーツアクターで、高校時代は体操競技をやってて、機械体操で、それを生かすためにスタントマンっていう職業を選んで、もうスタントマンになった時からスーツアクターをだ。
Just like me, when I first started drawing, I wanted to draw Godzilla. Nothing else.
俺はゴジラじゃない。
ウルトラマン。
ウルトラマン。
ウルトラマン。おお。
ドラ。ストミオンコーセン。These are my Godzilla comic. I brought one for each of you.
Thank you.
I'd like to get you guys to sign my Godzilla Terebi-kun. I got it signed! Arigato gozaimasu.
Kitagawa-san.
Arigato gozaimasu. Thank you so much. We got to the Sky Tree today and we're like, oh, it's kind of crappy outside today. Maybe we'll still be able to get a good view of a bit of the city. And it was closed. And so we get to the Tocho building and we finally get up here. And you can't see but a few hundred meters out the window. You know what? I figured it was a hell of a wrap up and it's a great way to do it. And I proposed up in the clouds. So we got engaged in Tokyo.
I was gonna do it at the top of the Sky Tree, originally.
I was kind of thinking about
it. See, I kept getting angry. I was like, come on, Sky Tree!
So,
there you go.
I think we'll be coming back very soon.